176,000 from sport and leisure means losing the complexes at Starthis and Weston. 895,000 from social services means closing Mainhead old people's home and cutting the hours at Haddonfield Day Nursery.
Even the children.
2.3 million from education. Do you think I joined the Labour Party at 16 in order to make cuts in services?
Then why are you doing it?
We have no choice. If we don't make these cuts, then it's 350 teachers' jobs. 200 public workers will be capped.
You can't do this. You're a disgrace, comrade.
The people out there have more intelligence than you credit them with.
Then why won't you let them in to hear us?
Hey, what's up with you? You tired?
Manoeuvre.
I'll give you a hand.
Christine, behave.
She's all right. What group are you in?
She's a swimmer.
Oh, aye. Nice kid.
We like her.
Can handle this.
Yeah, it's hardly 84, is it? Good people, these. We should be supporting them. When it comes to cuts, we're next. Time for the cricket, Frank, I think.
Responsibility of office, eh?
Well, somebody's got to do it.
Excuse me, sir, I don't think you should go down there.
I need to talk with the...
Then you tell me that.
They'll be a lot better off than they would be if we got capped, I'll tell you that.
Read DCC Berman.
He's
got it here. So keep crying.
He fought in two wars, would he?
He'll be transferred. He'll not be out on the street.
You shift him! You shift him, you'll kill him, would you? And you know that!
What about my tea dances, eh? Go on, smile! When you're my age, eh?
It is not us, it's the government, all right?
Come and get us out! Zulu, 2-1. You're going to have to come in.
Is it clear? Is it clear?
Go, go, go! Go, go!
He's the Met's expert on public order, the PCA have insisted. The local chief tried for one of his mates across the county border.
Clark, this is Deputy Assistant Commissioner John Conby.
Superintendent Tony Clark, sir.
Someone authorised the horses. You know the Manoeuvre 11 guidelines. Only canter the horses in if there's enough room for the crowd to disperse and only if it's serious rioting. I don't think there was either.
The chief constable is...
Don't ask. We want you up there as soon as possible.
Yes, straight away. I'm travelling up today. Nice to meet you, Tony.
Train's on the hour, Gov. Better go to 10 o'clock, yeah?
Wasn't there an earlier one?
No, I've got a liaison meeting.
Well, cancel it.
9 o'clock?
Can't cancel it. Got a presentation, there's Home Office people in, politicians.
What time?
9. I'm going to be late as it is. I can't not go.
11 o'clock, 12 o'clock.
That's too late.
You'll phone the minister then, will you, sir? 11.
10.
But that's the point. As MI5 adapts to reflect the changed international circumstances, our brief is to establish a working partnership with the police. A real partnership that works.
Sorry.
This is not going to be easy for either party. Even in the very recent past, there have been rivalries and what can only be described as cultural differences that have obstructed and seriously endangered operations of both services.
Why don't I come with you? Yeah, I've got a mate up there, John Jennings. I was at university with him. He's a planner now. I could give him a ring. I could join you tomorrow.
Richard, I'll be working.
Well, the evenings.
Not necessarily. In fact, I'd say almost definitely not.
Sick of this.
What?
One of us is trying so hard to keep this relationship going.
Richard, please don't do this to me now.
Well, you get such a kick out of it, don't you? Being out there, you know, amongst the action. It means so much to you. It's so important. It's more important than our relationship.
Is there any way we can get a sandwich in it?
You haven't got time.
Pardon?
You have a train to catch. Conway thinks you're already halfway there.
What else do you know?
What else do you want to know?
Conway.
What's your impression?
Seems okay. He's Graves, but with backbone, intelligence and sense of humour.
And considerable ambition.
Well, he'd have to get where he is.
Don't rely on him.
Thanks.
I would have liked a sandwich.
Assistant Chief Constable Jan Lewis.
Honoured to meet you, ma'am. I'm Superintendent Tony Clark, D.I. Harry Naylor, D.S. Maureen Connell.
relax.
They're in.
What are they like?
They're not smiling.
They're the Met. What do you expect? You want a drink?
Are you all right?
Fine, thanks.
Except he shit himself twice.
I thought you were going on the sick.
Yeah, any minute now.
This doesn't help.
Chief Constable Harmsworth. Deputy Berman. ACC Staff Services is Lewis. There's no ACC operations down here. Tattersall's next one down as Chief Superintendent. Well, Manoeuvre 11 has to be authorised. Someone must have been watching out for him.
I'll check it out.
How are you getting on?
Well, there's plenty of it, but the riot stuff so far is useless because it's handheld and they got shoved around. So there's lots of faces flashing past, fists flying, and then everybody's boots and shoes.
Gov, ACC officers have been off sick for a couple of months and they haven't made a temporary replacement. Berman was senior duty officer. Tattersall, duty officer at the scene.
Right. I'll go and see Tattersall. Harry, you get up to the hospital. Mo, go and have a chat with the inspector at the mounted section.
OK. Harry, you got an A to Z there, please?
We'll meet back at the hotel.
Yeah, I'm not going to the hotel. Going to brother-in-law's club.
Saving up for something?
Yeah.
OK, a pub. Which one?
Rising Sun.
Rising Sun, 6 o'clock.
Hello.
This cowardly attack upon my police officers has shocked us all. Some were even set upon as they went to the assistance of the injured and the dying. They're all heroes.
So these wounds were definitely inflicted by some sort of blade.
Yes,
like a Stanley blade or some such. So people were there looking for trouble.
Definitely.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Right. Could you just move that tail up again? Thanks. Again. Great.
Where were you standing? Would you like me to come back later?
Sorry. I thought I felt a move. No. We were right at the front first off, at the barrier. We were getting crushed. So I asked the policeman if we could come through to get out. He told me to F off. So we started to fight our way through to the back to get out that way. Then we saw the horses. There were a panic. I held on to Christine. Mick had hold of Philip. She went down. I was holding her tight, but I got a knock. I still had hold of her hand. I wouldn't let go. I was crouching over her. She was screaming. Everybody was screaming.
You've got a good riot going, so yeah, really good riot. And yeah, get the horses in. Sticks out. People either get cracked over the head, knocked over, or bugger off out of it sharpish.
Was this a good riot?
Oh, I couldn't tell you that. They kept us out of sight down a side street. You'll have to ask the men in charge. We just do as we're told.
There was a council meeting at 2:30 to discuss next year's plans for the budget. Now, it was no secret that very considerable cuts in public services were going to be announced. We did receive advance notice from some public sector unions, community groups, their supporters, that they were going to turn up to protest.
Any idea of numbers?
We estimated about 1,500.
And you had sufficient officers to deal with the situation?
In my opinion, yes, but we did also receive intelligence reports that a group were going to turn up who intended simply to use the demonstration as a means of disrupting the council meeting. They were going to attack the town hall.
How did you deal with them?
I cordoned off the town hall.
Using metal barriers?
Yes.
Why did you decide to deploy the mounted section?
The situation became very dangerous.
For whom?
For everyone. There'd been a change in mood when this group of anarchists turned up and infiltrated the crowd. The situation deteriorated badly. The leader of the council, the Councillor Woods, came out, tried to reason with the crowd. Now, he was grabbed, and an attempt was made to pull him into the crowd. In the mayhem that followed, children were in danger of being crushed. So I decided to use the mounted section to force the crowd off into the side streets either side of the town hall.
And there was ample space for the crowd to disperse?
Yes.
And you were authorised by the Deputy Chief Constable for this procedure?
Yes, I had the authority of a general order immediately prior to sending in the mounted section.
Right, well, I think that covers everything.
I mean, what is it about Doctor's sense of humour?
Harry, over here.
What are you, Harry?
Left to ask.
Who knows what bad habits you got into since you've been away?
Jarvis is my governor, Tony Clark.
Howdy, Tony. That's not a job to brag about in here, especially at a time like this.
Right. You haven't seen any redheads knocking around, have you?
I ain't talking.
Excuse me. Are you dining alone?
Yes.
Would you mind at all if I joined you?
No. No, you're welcome.
I've got a meeting here in one of the conference rooms at 8, and it's a bit of a rush to get home and back.
Yeah, I'm sure.
And it's not bad, this place. Quick, not at all pretentious.
Good.
Are you passing through?
Yeah, well, just a few days, I hope.
I run a freight business here. Should we have some wine?
Yes.
What are you eating? Have the fish.
Right, I will.
That one.
What's your meeting?
Women's Network. An excuse to get together for women in the arts, business, public service management. Well, you should come. Are you doing anything?
I hadn't planned to.
Well, then come as my guest. They've a really interesting speaker tonight, Jan Lewis. She's one of the top policewomen in the country. Well, you must have heard of her.
Yes. Yes, I have.
We're all friends here, are we? No reporters. Well, then think of the police as a solid block of male attitudes. Prejudiced, sexist, racist, ignorant, violent. A culture based on unchallengeable certainties. But it's steadfast. And those ingredients are what give it strength. But events such as yesterday's are a blow to that confidence. Obviously, when innocent people are killed or injured, someone might have got it wrong. Or we'll find that someone. But our omnipotence has been dealt a serious blow.
Well, how are we, Sheila?
She's all right.
Well, she gets a bit fed up. You know what she's like.
Mary would have come down, you know.
No, no need. I mean, she can cope, you know. Thanks, Mary.
Maureen, I wonder where you got to. Let me introduce you.
Has this been part of your investigation, Sergeant?
No, ma'am. Purely recreational. I was invited.
I invited her.
I didn't give you anything to run back to Superintendent Clark with, did I, Sergeant?
I didn't hear anything that I wouldn't be willing to endorse, ma'am.
Well, that's something to be thankful for. Good night.
I'll see you in a minute.
Steady as you go, Joe.
Just going for a pee. How is it that whenever your Joe goes for a pee, he comes back with 3 pints?
It's an old family tradition.
What did they think when you started courting Joyce?
Well, they were less than thrilled, I can tell you. But they've been all right over the years. They never change, you know?
Do you know what's wrong with her?
No.
nothing definite, no.
Don't bullshit me.
I'm not bullshitting you. When I know, I'll tell you.
Well, it's the world she lives in.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Sorry, it's just that Dan's been a really good friend to me. It's a cab.
Keep in touch.
I will.
Good night, was it, Gov?
Yeah. Listen, I'm sorry about earlier. It's just me and Harry got...
No, don't worry about it. You weren't missed.
If you could all settle down, please. The Chief Constable has a statement to make.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. 2 days ago, in this fine city, a violent and politically motivated group of people orchestrated a major public order disaster. This morning, thanks to some fine detective work, several houses were raided and arrests were made. You can see on the table here some of the weapons which were deployed against my officers. Posters and leaflets have been circulated for some days, urging people to march on the town hall, take it over. This is a grouping well known to us. A collection of splinter factions, known under the umbrella title of class struggle.
How do you answer charges of excessive force?
Chief Constable, are we going to get a chance to speak to Chief Superintendent Tattersall?
Funerals, Chief Constable.
I'm sorry, I don't know you.
Chris Priestley from the Independent.
We have nothing to hide, Mr. Priestley. Officers were appointed by me to make decisions on the day, but I take full responsibility for the actions of the police connected with the demonstration.
Will you be visiting any of the civilian injured in hospital, Chief Constable?
Are you going to apologise, Chief Constable?
I've already done so, Mr. Priestley.
Are you going to say sorry?
And offered my deeply felt condolences to their relatives.
Who issued the order for the use of sticks?
Jeff Woods, leader of the council, chair of the police committee.
Hello.
I've got one or two things to say about this, if you've got the time.
Not worried about this for years, you know. These wild kids. Old bastards like Tommy Burton. They never give up, you know. Man, it's that pillock I'll blame. It was stood next to me. I was dragged into the crowd, he never saw it. I thought I was a goner. He's looking the wrong way.
I'm sorry, who is it that we're talking about?
Tattersall. Bloody hopeless. It was chaos round here all day, you know. Oh, it didn't just suddenly flare up. Oh, no, they had a chuffing carnival going on.
A carnival?
Oh, aye. You know, rides on fire engines, all that arty jewellery. They were here setting stalls up at 8 o'clock in the morning. They were selling samosas and every kind of vegetable, politically correct, make your farting pastry by 8:30. Well, Tattersall, he should have cleared him off when the demo started. Oh, not him. Never put a foot right all day. If there was a bollock to drop, he dropped it.
Mr. Burton, you were picked up this morning as a prime mover in the demonstration. What can you tell us about class struggle?
reckless. Not really. Handful of lunatics.
Do you deny that there are or have been associations between you and other people picked up this morning?
Associations? I know them. I hate some of them.
Why is that?
The tossers. Son, it's left politics we're talking here. Son, what's your name?
Clark.
You don't mind me asking, do you? Your first name?
Tony.
Will you indulge an old man, Tony? You see, I'm getting a bit out of touch these days. I can't see the old patterns. Where do you come from? What's history?
What do you mean?
Well, bear with me, Tony. You see, my dad, he was a collier. He took me out of school at 14 and took me down pit. His father was a collier, my grandfather. Now, his father was a farm labourer. Now, what about your family?
My father was a shop floor manager.
Ah. Metals?
Woolworths.
Your grandfather?
I think he was a clerk on the railways.
And what about you, love?
My dad was an engineer who became a teacher. His father and his father's father were in the yards.
Ah. And his dad before that, I bet. You see, Tony, she burns this one. She burns with an anger you probably never felt. Blood thinning out over the generations. We fight because we have to. Because if we don't, we go under. You've never had to fight, have you, Tony?
What about the riot, Mr. Burton?
I was a steward on the march. I'm an old age pensioner member of the Trades Council. I volunteered. No plots. I don't do them anymore.
Yeah, Angela Berridge, please. Tony Clark.
Thanks for some fine detective work. Several houses were raided and arrests were made.
Tony, I'm watching it.
Yeah, I've just been with Burton. He gave me a lecture on class. Apparently it's all in the genes.
Good for him. Old Tommy's a dying breed. You should see the files we have on him. He thought Stalin was right to send tanks into Hungary.
Listen, we need another meeting soon.
Why?
To discuss our future together.
Well, I'm far too busy for a sandwich. Might be able to fit in a quick breakfast.
I'd like you to tell me what you know about class struggles, sir.
I'm sorry, I don't follow.
Well, the official line is that this riot was precipitated by a ruthless organisation determined to seek every opportunity to foment civil strife. And that this riot needed the urgent intervention of the mounted section to bring it under control, to defeat class struggle. What I'm asking you, sir, is how many political agitators does it take to cause a riot?
Sounds rather hypothetical to me, Clark.
Well, then let me put it another way. Was the mounted section sent in to bring under control a riot which, so far as we can establish, may have been caused by two men and a dog? Class struggle. Or was this riot a direct result of the mounted section being sent in?
Certainly not.
Can you define the riot, sir?
Pressure on police lines and barriers.
That's not a riot, that's a crush.
Dangerous objects being thrown by aggressively disposed individuals.
Who were defending themselves against the mounted section. It now seems that this demonstration started much earlier than we were led to believe. 8 in the morning.
No, it didn't. Not the demonstration, just some people setting up stalls.
Some, not hundreds.
We weren't concerned with them.
They were setting up their stalls all around the square.
Yes.
Clark.
And the ambulance service and the fire brigade were there with their stuff to show what they do.
You know they did. It was a sort of a carnival.
Right. I think we'll just leave it there. Interview concluded 14:35. Good.
I'm supposed to be clocking these laps. Our fill's in.
Yeah, I just need to ask you a few questions. You said you were trying to leave the demonstration.
Yes.
Why?
Well, it were getting a bit nasty, you know. Lots of bad language.
Who was this?
Well, kids, really. Students, perhaps.
How many of them?
Only a few. We just happened to be near them, but most of the people there were like us, you know.
Yes, such as?
There were teachers, nurses, miners. And, you know, they're closing down the tea dances, and they were there. There must have been a couple of dozen more earlier on, and not one of them under 70. It would that kind of do, you know.
Yeah, look, before the horses came, did you hear a warning of any kind?
No.
Are you sure now? I mean, it must have been very noisy.
No, not that noisy. I heard Oak Rest. He was talking into his radio, and he was getting pushed and shoved, but we were all laughing, you know. Nobody warned us about horses.
Mick! Mick! It's the hospital.
Watch much football, Tony?
Not much, too busy.
Yeah, it's all crap down there, is it? Those hooligans.
What?
It's usually horses. Must have pulled them out. Hey, you picked up Tommy Burton?
Not us.
Same thing.
You know him?
Yeah, he used to work with my uncle in Pitt during war. They went on strike over meal breaks. He's always been at it. Stands in local elections. Beats Liberals, Tories. People don't vote for his party, but they respect him. He sorts problems, paperwork for people that can't see, can't read. Amazing who he knows and who he can get a favour out of. He's old, he's tired and he's knackered, but he's still fighting. You know something, Tony? You can fool some of the people some of the time, but if you've picked up Tommy Burton, then every bugger knows you're covering up for someone.
It's not us, Joe, we're independent.
Yeah, well, you're pissing the same pot.
Tattersall give you proper clearance?
The heat's off class struggle, you know. That excuse is falling apart.
Aye, well, I mounted section me. I'm not a detective. Nothing to do with me.
Yeah, and they're from Horse and Hound. Oh, look this way. If they can't blame class struggle, Inspector, then they're going to be coming for you.
Aye, well, it can sod off. We're not the ones to blame. We're the fire brigade. They don't call us in unless it's already too late, unless some other bugger's screwed up.
Tattersall.
If they got half a brain, when they want to use my section, they ask my advice. I'm the expert.
What would you have done?
I'd have gone in earlier, much earlier. Walked the horses in, shoved the crowds away from the bastard barriers.
Tattersall thought he had a serious riot on his hands.
Aye. Go, 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 go! What does he know about it? He was in staff services till a month ago. You don't charge barriers. Barriers are cleared out of the way first. Barriers are bad news. The horses get stuck in them, or the bastards sling them at you. And if Tarastel didn't know that, then somebody should have been there to put him right.
Sir, we need to speak to DCC Berman, sir, if that's possible.
The Deputy Chief Constable is ill.
Come to try and save your boy. Didn't know you liked boys.
Sir, I have asked the Chief Constable to call you in to speak to Convey and CIB. I've tried to keep out of this, but I'm formally telling you, as my immediate superior officer, if neither you nor the Chief Constable will acknowledge what happened, I'll go to Convey and tell him myself.
You stupid bitch.
Look, you've got to come in, Frank.
All this would have blown over in a few days.
Do you know, I don't know what function you serve any longer on this force. I can't work out, can't add up what it is we get for our money. You don't take crooks, you don't do paperwork, you play no observable part in strategy. Whatever Jim Tattersall didn't know, he'll learn faster for what happened the other day.
Bollocks.
You're going to tell Convey what you were doing. What state you were in when you were supposed to be senior duty officer.
Really? Can't do it, can you? Just lick him. You're all the same. When it comes to it, no bottle. We ignored him, you know. He bleeped us, and we had another drink. Let's see if she can dig him out of this one. That's what the chief said. And he was right. You see, you stick your nose in, and you get it shoved right back out again. Now piss off! Go on! Piss off!
Where were you when the riot started?
I was with Councillor Woods.
Why?
I had accompanied him into the crowd.
So you were under attack?
Yes, at the end.
It's very commendable to be active at the heart of things. In retrospect, was it the best place from which to take strategic decisions?
We don't have state-of-the-art surveillance equipment. I wanted to be close to the situation as it developed.
Of course. Clark.
There is no ACC responsible for operations, sir. Who do you answer to? A DCC Berman. Was he at the town hall? He was elsewhere, on police business.
Did you seek advice from DCC Berman at any time?
I spoke to him at intervals during the day. What about the period immediately before the riot? It was difficult. Undoubtedly. Did you try? Of course. Did you succeed? No.
So, the decision to send in the mounted section was entirely your own.
Yes.
You can't abandon him, sir.
Why not? He's screwed up.
I don't think that he was the only one.
Oh, don't you now?
No, sir.
Who else, then?
Sir, we are now the only force in the country not running mandatory public order courses for senior officers. In the case of inexperienced officers like Tattersall...
Bloody panicker.
Sir, I have always believed that management is a responsibility, not a privilege. DCC Berman...
Yes?
He needs treatment, sir. Oh, come on, surely you admit that? He's a sick man.
Do I detect criticism of me behind all this?
Well, sir, in the final analysis, it was you who dropped Tattersall in it. You and Berman. What happened wasn't an accident. It was a tragedy born of negligence. Tattersall may well be accused of criminal negligence, but you and I both know that lack of training, communication, the way decisions are made, the whole practice of management here made something like this inevitable. At the very least, Berman should have been there with him, not getting drunk at the bloody cricket with you.
God, I know what she needs.
Sorry?
It's politics. You know, politics. All down to police committees. Loony lefties, bent bastards, ban the bombers. Feminists, lesbians. I have to carry the shit they offload. I've a gender-adjusted senior management team. They scoured the country looking for a suitable black. 10 years it's taken me to pull them back into line.
Sir, I have to tell you that we've spoken to Tattersall now on 3 occasions.
Yes, well, I'm a bit worried about him myself, to tell you the truth.
Sir, I am aware of how volatile the situation is at the moment. I want to handle this with great care.
There are funerals next week. Timing is everything.
But in order to conclude our investigation, sir, we feel we should speak to DCC Berman.
No.
Sir, it's my opinion we must speak to DCC Berman if this inquiry is to command public confidence.
And that's your opinion, is it, Sonny Jim? Well, you can piss off with your public confidence. I don't care about your public bloody confidence. I'm battling for this police force.
Sorry.
It's only 5 past.
The train was late. 5:23, due in at 7:35. Delayed.
You came down this morning?
Dead cow on the line.
I don't believe it.
I didn't want to talk on the phone. You never know who might be listening.
Oh, is that the reason?
No.
Hello? Hello? Downstairs. Well, come on up. No, sure, it's all right. Room 214. Okay.
I'm getting nowhere fast with Berman. Can you help me get hold of the ACC Ops, the one who's been ill?
The ACC Ops isn't ill. He's been suspended.
What? Why?
4 of his lads had a bit of fun with the probationer. Pretended they were armed robbers. Took him hostage. Beat him about a bit, put a gun in his mouth.
Oh, shit.
Yes, everyone had a thoroughly good time and was highly amused, and the boy had a nervous breakdown. The ACC Ops is Berman's protege. And the officer who took the matter up forced it to a disciplinary.
Don't tell me.
Lewis. Come on in.
Jan Lewis came to my house last night. She's very distressed. She wants to be interviewed over this riot business. She's got information.
Right. Well, I have to phone my governor. I didn't know that she was directly involved.
Well, it's not easy for her to volunteer.
It's dangerous. Ah, he's not there, I'll try reception.
Well, what else is there? Well, this is it.
Let's walk around again.
You've got to go. Go on, bugger off.
Thanks.
Thank you.
You been?
What's wrong? What's up?
ACC Lewis wants to be interviewed.
Oh, Christ.
And Tattersall's making a statement at 11:30.
Where's Convey?
He's in with Harmsworth now. He's been avoiding us, Gulf. I've been trying to contact you since 8 this morning. Nobody knew where you were.
Are you saying they'd made themselves deliberately unavailable, ma'am?
Yes. I believe so.
Sir, can I have a word?
Not now, Clark.
We've got a problem.
Look, can't it wait?
We need you in there, John.
I'll be in straight away.
So I've been speaking to Mrs. Lewis for some information.
Is she any support for what she says? Can she prove it?
I'm sure she can.
Are you? It's just gossip, filtering down.
With respect, sir.
You have a way of saying with respect, sir, that denotes the precise opposite. Are you aware of that, Mr. Clark?
As the officer in charge of operations last Monday, I have to say with deep anguish and remorse that I made a serious misjudgment during the most difficult and taxing moments of the day.
Tattersall is covering up for massive mistakes by his superiors. He should never have been left on his own.
All we've got is an officer. A very decent officer who simply got out of his depth.
Sir, they have got that guy in there so screwed up, he will cough for all the unsolved crimes in the county. Harmsworth and Berman were criminally negligent.
Some of us have to look at the wider picture. You don't pull down a chief constable just to please the Guardian.
In a moment of crisis outside the town hall, when it appeared to me that lives and property were at risk, I ordered in the mounted unit. Without giving adequate warning of my intention, and without ensuring that there was sufficient space into which the crowd could disperse.
Will you resign?
Is this a matter for prosecution, Chief Constable?
Compensation regarding
will there be a
Chief
public inquiry?
Will you resign?
Are you accepting sole responsibility?
Well, 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 well,
will there be a public inquiry?
Chief Superintendent Tattersall hasn't tried to cover anything up. He's admitted to a mistake. Everybody and anybody makes them. He hasn't made us wait for a destructive inquiry that would have impeded the normal policing of this city. Seeing the likely consequences of such an inquiry, acting entirely on his own initiative, he has made this statement. I restate the pride in my officers.
Did you have a message?
Are you, Mr.